Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you Karn's modification for timeout timer calculation in TCP. See, timeout timer calculation, that should be dynamic, and that calculation I have explained you by two different algorithms. In my last two videos, I have explained how we can have Jacobson's algorithm for timeout timer calculation, as well as how we can have basic algorithm for a timeout timer calculation. And see, this timeout timer, which is T0, that calculation should be dynamic. And if you observe, see this T0, that is dependent on NRTT, and NRTT is dependent on ARTT. ARTT means actual round trip time. If you observe basic algorithm, in that, this T0, timeout timer, that is based on actual round trip time. If you observe Jacobson's algorithm, in that also you see NRTT is based on ARTT, and you see this T0, that is based on NRTT. So indirectly you can say T0 is based on ARTT. ARTT means actual round trip time. So dynamic calculation of T0, that is based on actual round trip time. So if you have actual round trip time, then you can easily calculate dynamic value of T0. And you see, what is T0? T0 is timeout time period, and after timeout there will be retransmission of packet. So practically, as if you don't receive acknowledgement, as if you don't receive acknowledgement, or as if your acknowledgement is delayed, and as if your ARTT is greater than timeout timer, then how will you calculate T0? See, T0 calculation, that is based on ARTT. But if you don't have ARTT, then how will you calculate T0? Obviously, you will be doing retransmission, right? If your acknowledgement is not received before T0, then you will be doing retransmission. But if you don't receive acknowledgement, then for next packet, what should be the value of T0? T0 is there based on ARTT, but right now you don't have ARTT. So what you will be doing? In that situation, you will be using Karn's modification, you see. So Karn's modification, that explains you what timeout timer, that should be calculated dynamically, and it will be based on actual round trip time. But what if ARTT is greater than T0? See, if you have ARTT lower than T0, then there will be proper transmission, that you can say. But as if this ARTT is greater than T0, then you will have to do retransmission. And as if you do retransmission, in that case you don't have ARTT. If you do retransmission, then you don't have ARTT. Then how to find T0? For that, you will have to use Karn's modification. You see what we need to do. If T0 is lower than ARTT, then there will be retransmission. But dynamic calculation of T0 is based on ARTT, and ARTT will be missing in case of retransmission. So in this situation of retransmission, we will be using Karn's modification. In that, T0 calculation, that will be as per double value of T0 with every retransmission. Like, you see, what we are doing is, if I show you one practical scenario, in that, if you observe here, this source is transmitting frame to destination by one segment. Now you see here T0 value, that is 5 milliseconds, so that is up to this time only, right? But if you observe, acknowledgement comes over here, and this time period is ARTT, actual round trip time. And if you observe ARTT here, actual round trip time here, that is greater than T0. So as this ARTT, that is greater than T0, here there will be retransmission. After a timeout, there will be retransmission. But with this retransmission, this source is not having data of ARTT. So in this situation, this source will be using Karn's modification for T0, in which what it will be doing is, now it will be doubling the value of T0 compared to previous value. So now it will keep T0 value 10 milliseconds. And it will be doing retransmission here. The reason is, right now after T0 timeout, this source is not having actual round trip time. In that situation only, remember, in that situation only, it will be using Karn's modification where it will be doubling the value of T0. Now it will be 10 milliseconds. It will be doing retransmission. Again, it will be waiting for acknowledgement. Now here, if you observe this ARTT, this ARTT, you see, again, this ARTT, that is greater than this T0. So after T0, there will be again retransmission. But as this source is not having idea about what is ARTT, what it will be doing? It will be simply doubling the value of T0 and it will be doing retransmission. And now you see, when it is doing retransmission, at that time, T0 value will be double than this. So it will be now 20 millisecond. It will be double than this, right? It will be 20 millisecond now. So now you see here, acknowledgement comes within this time range. This time ARTT, that is slow, that is smaller than T0. So that's why, what will happen? Now there is no need of retransmission. So practically, see, T0 value, that should be greater than ARTT. That should be greater than ARTT for proper transmission. But what if ARTT is greater than T0? There will be retransmission. And as you do retransmission, at that time you will be doing Karn's modification, in which you will be doubling the value of T0. See, if you do retransmission in that situation, remember, you don't have ARTT at that instant. You see, here T0 timeout is happening at this instant. So at this instant, I don't have ARTT. And as I don't have ARTT, what I'll be doing? I'll be simply doubling the value of T0 from here onwards, and I'll be doing retransmission. Dynamic value of T0, that we do it as per algorithm. Remember, in that you do have ARTT. Right? You see, when we were been dynamically calculating that T0 over here, right? At that time, we were been having ARTT of last segment, If you don't have ARTT of last segment, in that case only, you will have to do that Karn's modification. Otherwise, simple calculation that we need to follow as per Jacobson's algorithm for timeout timer, or you do have second algorithm, that is basic algorithm for timeout timer, right? So this is how two algorithms that we have studied in my last two videos. But in those two algorithms, if you have retransmission, then you don't have ARTT. What it means here, ARTT is greater than T0. And as if ARTT is greater than 0, then you cannot apply basic algorithm as well as Jacobson's algorithm. In that situation, you'll have to use Karn's modification. And as if you use Karn's modification, in that simply you will be doubling the value of T0, right? And you will be doing retransmission of data. That is how things are happening for a timeout timer calculation in TCP. I hope you have enjoyed it. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.